Alright, I want to talk also first. I speak directly in more of a Russian accent, particular for my singing. It's very stressful to speak American on my voice. I've had a terrible problems with my American speaking voice being harsh, aggressive to my arias. So I'll get that out of the way. That's been confusing for persons. Why is she speaking this way when this is my sister or whatever? The arias are more important than my American accent. So let's get that out of the way. I wanted to speak history today. I wanted to speak history, histoire. Very, very interesting history with the I want to go back to the gold. I want to go back to the ore. The ore is here. It's what it is called in France. The gold is quite a momentum in history and where it went. Now, my particular grandfather, my grandfather was there. He's a Kennedy. He's also from the Kennedy line. We are from the Kennedys of America, and they are also originally the Kennedys from the northern Scots, northern Scotlands of Angleterre, of England. So these Kennedys, now interesting. They could have met up in the Ireland. I you know, everywhere, but yes, in the roundabout of it. From the direct of the south, it's a quite interesting line, my bow line all the way to the Berry, because it is a one line is specifically from the grandfather, from his direct descendant, from the very south of the Bow de Provence. So he came from the south. They invented the trebuchet, the catapults. They left. They went to the north, very early on, and so they went to the north, and then they had many finaglings there, with France yet again, back to the crown of France, and so they were there fighting, with the Montgomery. Then there was a Montgomery there with the Berry. They're called the Duke de Berrys. They had all of their Berrys again and again and again, and many of them became the kings through time. So these Berrys also, later on, I have discovered that we are related to the Berry war. And so it is interesting. So I actually come from the fight, the aggress from the south that wanted the rule of the monarchy through the vow name, and then also the ones that came in through I believe it was the House of the Valois, they call it. Not a beautiful group, but yes, that particular group, they came in, so the aggress ended up in the same family as a marriage, and so that's very interesting. So I am coming from the fight from the south to the Berry, yet within the same blood. So it's an interesting merger, and here in France, from the Scottish, and bringing that Montgomery in. I don't know quite the history of the Montgomery. I just know that they were here with the French in an aggression. But yeah, also interesting is the Kennedy in there, because it brings immediately political. It brings immediate political. I'm just learning this. This is all brand new for me, all of these names. And so when I'm finding in this discovery the Kennedy there, it is bringing many realizations as to why. And I'm like, well, I was tear gassed there in the Zurich specifically. And so I'm thinking, well, that could be something to do with it. It could be something to do with my particular lineage, my song. They call it the song, the blood, the song, the ligne, I believe so. So yeah, so it's very interesting this merger. I know it is difficult when it isn't inside you as one person, that you were the person that was aggressing and for one particular monarchy specific. So it has been the fight for France many times again over. So it's interesting group, political. But yeah, I don't know the, you know, I'm not a capture gainer on the Kennedy either. However, I do believe my second oldest brother is quite a likeness of JFK. If you look at him, he does have quite a resemblance. And also I believe he was my uncle from, that would be odd also if he was the uncle from the brother's side. That would be another marriage to it, but he does have a resemblance. But what I'm saying directly is my second oldest brother from that line, from the vow line, from the Kennedy marriage there, has very, very much a likeness to JFK. So, but with the red hair. But with the red hair, which is interesting also. And yes, I also notice Miranda and Saru, we seem to have in the line, we go many oftentimes with a family that is the mother and father with the darker hair, and then the children all of a sudden are blonde and or the red hair. And so it's extremely confusing. To the parents, they're having the blonde children, and then the children are having the darker haired children, and then their children are having in succession more blonde children, more lighter haired red hairs. So yeah, and so the darker red hair, I believe, is coming in from the further south in the Navarre, from that region, from the Fontaine. Group. So I don't know. Was not really trying to talk that today. I'm trying to speak more. I'm trying to speak more about the gold. I want to speak of the gold there in the southwest, and what happened originally. My grandfather was, like I said, he was in the bad business dealings, and he lost half of his fortune. Well, not half. He lost pretty much all of it. And it was such a massive fortune, it could have been in the States of $100 million at the time. And when it was gone, when this money was gone, it was gone overnight to his partner. He lost the business to his partner. He had to give it up. Now, I believe this was before the peso drop. This was all before the peso collapse. There was a major peso collapse. So what happened with him is he ended up he had to pay back his partner, his business partner, because he's an honest man. He had to pay him back for the losses. So in the paying back for the losses, he ended up being a worker for one of the conglomerates that he owned, a contractor worker. And he worked there on the Trans Mountain and in El Paso there in Texas. And he was working there, and I believe they are taking the gold from the mountain there. Now, excuse me, because they're taking the gold from the mountain of Trans Mountain for many years, and they're also taking the rocks and the stones. But they took the gold and they took it into the foundries and they washed it and they sold it out of the El Paso State Bank. And through there, they ended up feeding that gold back into the Federal Reserve. And so they supported the economy quite elaborately with the commodity again and again as a regular ritual. So it was a steady flow. So my particular grandfather was the stability that was necessary for the United States to retain their momentum with the Federal Reserve stance throughout all of the years of all of the wars. He was there, right there on American soil, absolutely harvesting gold. So, in poverty, in a total poverty state, because by that time the peso had dropped and he had lost, I believe, 10 million in equivalency. On that last drop, he lost 10 million. So it was gone, all gone. Now, when we are looking at this tremendous time frame, the family was completely disheartened. We were sent down river essentially because there was no money, and yet there is the family member there that is the Cooper Car Company. Now the Cooper Car Company, the one of the Mini Cooper, they were the ones that we were in association with, having to pay back close to 90 million. So, so my grandfather's working there, paying back this 90 million, and Mr. Cooper is accepting it, and making his business deals, in purchasing the car company, and other things most likely. So that is where the money went. So essentially we ended up being I'm the grandchild of this father who originally was the digger, the gold digger, specifically to supply the money in payback form to be transferred to Mr. Cooper to pay for the car companies. So he brought the car companies of the Mini Cooper and also the Mercedes into play right there in Vance, Alabama. So it's a long line of honesty, actually, of absolute honesty with business. Never one to harm. He lost it, and some say it was a card game. Some say, you know, we want to not even talk of how he lost it. So we don't speak it. I don't think he even wanted to really tell the truth. When the great fortune is gone, the great fortune is gone. But he worked steadily years, maybe 25 years into the Trans Mountain, digging out for the gold, having whatever was sifted through, sent to the foundry, whatever, melted down further on, sold back to the Federal Reserve. So quite a supportive entity in financial stability for the United States. Meanwhile, I don't believe all of the losses were recovered. I don't believe there was that much gold there, but I cannot say for certain. I do not know for certain. Nobody knows for certain how much was actually removed from that mountain. So this is a quandary. This is a quandary. And perhaps that information died when Mr. Cooper died. When Mr. Cooper died, I do not know if there was a clarity with how much he had in his in his particular rights over that board of directorship of ownership of the car company. I'm not sure what happened there. There may be legal battles going on right there behind my back already that nobody has informed me of. So there was a lot of gold there out of that mountain. So not necessarily the mountain of my grandfather, however, subsidiary ownership with the Cooper and others, so it does start to become the the payback for him. That was my grandfather. And so no, we're not a cheater family. We're not one of cheats. And now I'm thinking, extravagances that I'm seeing here. I get this little thing delivered here in France. You know, somebody is having a roundabout built, brand new roundabout in the middle of nowhere, you know, just for some big trucks to drive by. So it's obviously they're building infrastructure. They're building infrastructure specifically for, they're building infrastructure specifically for enterprise. And what is this business? What is this enterprise? Does anybody know that they are building infrastructure for? So they're taking the fund from this old government EU, from this old French government, and they are using it to make roundabouts and beautiful new roads for businesses. Now, to me, that seems like a little hand in the pocket. Seems like they are putting one hand into the government and giving it directly to a specific group of business persons, all under the guise that they may create another job, they may create more works. I'm not in famished with that mode of operating a government. I feel it is absolutely the wrong way to go. It is a business that is merely for who? You know, did those workers get the choice that that's a business they really want to be working in? It's a business for who? And who is the owners of the business that requires such extravagant road work? Who are the owners of that business? Are they even French? That is the question right now. We need to find out who owns these businesses. Who is owning the businesses that is receiving these infrastructures? Those businesses have no right to be receiving a direct action of finance gain, easy road ridings for their trucks. It's just the way it goes. So yeah, it becomes a handout party for who, you know, your select few get the handout party, where you have the population of the uneducated and riotous, just you know, so they think they are this new bourgeoisie of enterprise, together hand in hand, that they own the EU together, that they own the infrastructure, that they own the businesses together. It's a sick marriage, and that marriage has to stop. That mariage. I don't think they call it mariage here. I think they call it something else. Who cares, you know, so what for my French? Anyway, that marriage, the enterprise of the special few, that sounds so Argentina in a way, doesn't it? Just like the IMF, you know, they went in there and they just, well, they'll be our businesses, won't they? So I'm not impressed with this operation, and of operating a country, because I don't believe it is operating it at all. It's just operating a few financial pockets. The workers are never really getting any more money for the jobs. They can have other jobs, much better, much more of what they would prefer. Just someone else picking and choosing. You know what I mean? Picking and choosing. So what are they you know, saying, well, we place the jobs out there for them, and then they just walk into the work, and they walk into the factories, or they walk into the mines, they walk into all of it. You know, we just put the work out there, and they walk in. That's their stance. Well, I think the workers, given a little momentum into their brain, can actually rise above that education of just being pushed from one job stance to another job stance by a major enterprise. Owned by who? And money they're never going to see. They're just going to be remaining impoverished forever. You know, maybe they get middle class. So, I believe my father has had a stroke. Apologies to him for. I hope he gets better. They happen. They happen in our lives, and they just go on, no big deal. Just go on and try to find a good place to live. That's the main thing. I know there's an update of all kinds of information. My little brother, I get the gist from him that he does not want to claim monarchy. He doesn't want to be king ever. He doesn't think that it's possible, perhaps. Juan Carlos became king of Spain most recently, 1975, I believe. It's not emphatico, strange to all of a sudden become monarchy again. We are here on the internet. We are here on the internet, and we are conducting a monarchy right now. I am a family of the royals, and I am conducting monarchy here in France. And that is going to be forever until my dying day. It's not going away. We are dealing here with many, many facets. Many facets of politics. And if you don't understand them, well, you are my younger brother, aren't you? Perhaps you will not ever be a king. Maybe you don't have to understand all the politics. Perhaps I will outlive you. That's what I'm trying to get at. You're supposed to want to be king, you know. Your mother would think, yeah, hello, you're supposed to want to be king, you know, that is your birth, right. So I don't know, the whole thing with the Kennedys is weird, huh, because it is like a freak. It's like a freak show that's entered into the my genealogy bloodline. I'm like, oh no, not the Kennedys, because then I now see my second oldest brother, and he is looking extremely JFK, and like so cute in a way. They are so cute, and yet they're not cute because of the association with his assassination, and I'm like, oh my gosh. What was that all about? It was about dealings with Russia. He was there, and apparently America was so cold, froze, hardened that they could not handle a president that wanted to speak with Russia on an equal or level playing field and have politics as diplomacy. And so he was killed. That is exactly what happened. Now, here it is, this day and age, and here I am speaking my Russian accent, So I guess I have the leanings already in my blood. Isn't that bizarre? Because I found this out, like maybe, I don't know, just this last week, this Kennedy information. And so, and yet this whole time I've been speaking in this Russian accent special. It's quite funny because of his Russian. You know, it's no problem. You know, we'll not have this Cold War going on. We'll fix it and repair it. And they wanted the continuance of Cold War, and so, oh, Cold War is way over, and so I think there's no danger to me. However, there does seem to be a jinx on the family. There does seem to be a jinx on the Kennedy family, doesn't there? For a while, in people's minds, they think there's a jinx. But is it politics jinx only? I really believe it's because of dealings with Russia. Russia, are you dealing with Russia? Or are you not dealing with Russia? As an equal player, as persons out there that deserve the same money, that deserve the same payment, that deserve the same prices for their houses, all of these things. That's what we're talking about. That's exactly what we're talking about, is fairness. So if you do not want fairness with Russia, then essentially then you are JFK's assassinator also. Yeah, the old Bay of Pigs, they called it, and it was in Cuba. It had to do with the dealings of much of the sending oil specifically to Russia at a good price, and blah, blah, blah. So, I don't know. I guess that's enough of this history today. That's funny, huh? That's funny. And when you look at the line, I'm like, but my older brother doesn't look anything like the JFK group. You know, he doesn't have this jowly look. They get this big jowly look. And I'm like, well, it was a long time ago. But politics do crop up, you know. They just never left. They've never left my particular family. They just never have left. And so I believe, it is bizarre. It is a bizarre state when it actually does become an absolute look, reminiscent. But I'm like, what's the deal? What's the deal? You know, do I have to blame everything about me? You know, so I have particularly thin hair. So do I have to blame that on some Queen Elizabeth? You know, because of my Coventry name. You know, and am I really the association of Queen Anne Margaret? You know, like it is saying in the genealogy, am I really like some closer relation to Queen Anne Margaret? Now, if I am this closer relationship to Queen Anne Margaret, then yes, it does put us closer and closer and closer to the throne now today of Britain. I don't want to be there, so I'm not refusing it, but I don't want to be there. They're just I don't know. At this part, it's too much of a parade. They've just they're just parading around, and I don't know how they're gonna to free themselves. I don't know how they're gonna free themselves from that parade, and they're such like they need this. For some reason, and why are we giving it to them in a way? Why are we giving England, you know? Why are we giving England, oh, they get the 20 years of preparation that they're getting the King William. Why are they getting the 20-year preparation of this King William? When in reality, kings from the past, queens from the past, happened within a day, and the people accept it. Why now this party of entertainment? why now this preparation? We have to prepare the people, they have to love us, you know. It seems such a weak monarchy rule, doesn't it? It's a weak rule. It's a rule that is like dependent on propaganda machine. They have to be like fed into their minds and fed into their minds again and again. We have a king, we have a king, we have a king. Just like some kind of a weird, like a trance. Like you have to put the persons into a trance again and again and again. You know, teach them, teach them. We have a king and his name is William. Why are you worried? Why would this King William, why would any of them be worried of what the people think? If it's their true bloodline. Way too much propaganda, way too much parade. So anyway, what do you want me to say today more? That was kind of interesting. I know these are terrible videos in this place, but it's the way life goes at the moment. Well, my garden is not doing so great. I don't know, I put the stupid flax seeds there by accident, and coriander, and that became the sprout up, coriander and flax. And because of the coriander and flax, it just took over everything. And so it became a notorious weed show. They're easy enough to pull, but they're terrible. They're terrible, and I don't know. I don't know, it's not great. I did have the idea, though, for good King René to bring himself down to the Beau de Provence, the castle there, the restoration project, and the wheels. Deal with those wheels. Those are wooden wheels. There is a trebuchet that they built a long time ago that you built in your own blood. That is wooden, a wooden one, a car vehicle. Now it is very interesting, and perhaps from there it will entrance you into some kind of. I know you're dedicated to cars and the mechanics of them. I know you are dedicated to the vehicle, and so because of this, because you are this dedicated, well, it's just there for you on the platter, isn't it? For both you and your youngest brother. Your youngest brother are you know, as the woodworker. As the woodworker, he has a place right there. He can work the car, the wood of it, and you can build the races. And you can build the races with the cars and be funny with those. I imagine they could be equipped to some kind of a race. But I don't know. Maybe I'm just being silly. You know, I'm just being silly. You all just want to be Americanas. You just want to be Americana normals. You want to pretend that you're nothing. You want to be the same old that is a neighbor next door. I think not. I think not at all. I think you're just perhaps thinking, why now? I'm old, and I have to go through detox to cleanse all of the heavy metals out of my body. That's what you're thinking. That's no big deal. You just drink your green drinks. That's very simple. You drink your green drinks. Now, if you're going into epilepsy because you're out in the sun too gosh dang much, well, you have to stay away from the bright sunshine. I would leave that house. The house is horrible. If it's bringing you into an epilepsy, I would leave that house. It brought your little dog there, Fred, into epilepsy. So it could be something in the water also. So, well, When I say move, I mean everybody, everybody. Just pick up and go. Go down to, there is the Lord's. That is the family's name down there, the Fountain of Youth. Go to the Lord's, or go down to the Beau de Provence. And do something there. Do something there and begin something great with your life, rather than remaining a ritual of the masses. Another in the masses. I don't know why I have to give this pep talk. It's just getting gross. I am wondering where my second eldest brother is in leadership, because I already know he is prepared. I already know he is prepared to be political leader. I am absolutely disheartened with my eldest brother acting like such a little brat. And his wife, if that is his wife any longer, I don't know. They appear to be having divorcee symptoms. If that's going on, then get it on with and get it over with then. That was awful. Don't send that on the internet, please. That is a sabotage act from her, actually. And I believe that is not a woman who loves the man any longer. So I don't know. I guess I'm not really married, technically, any longer, because the husband has left me so long. I believe I'm not technically married. I imagine somebody has to say so. Deed it. It's done. I mean, I something happened to him. Something happened to him mentally. Now, do I cancel the marriage because of the mental state of him that he is not equipped to understand? He could have been poisoned. This whole thing, now the Kennedys have brought out this since this last week. He could have been poisoned. There is no possible way I can actually say in certainty. Oh no, it's a freaky day. My bed, I fix it. No, he's not here. he's not here. He said he's left the EU. He's gone to Cyprus or something. And I'm thinking, well, that's interesting. Because he said, he calls me, he says, why don't you go to Cyprus? How do I go to Cyprus by myself in the chickens and the ducks? How do I just do that? And I have no vehicle, I have no way of getting out of this house. As I said, I live many, many miles away. I do not communicate with the neighbors because I do not, at this point in time, trust them. They appear to be not able to associate with me as a normal situation. They appear to want to only harass me. So in their harassment, no, I'm not asking them for a ride to town. I don't know. Where's the gold everybody wants to know still? I imagine that's what had happened. It ended up funding the stability of the Federal Reserve and and purchasing the car companies of Alabama there. So there. That's the answer for today. What else did you want? I don't know. I'll clarify also the Kent name is Kemp. It was originally Kemp, K-E-M-P, and it is the old name for Kent, which is the region of England. And I also want to, back to gosh, they look terrible. The Valois and the other Oise, they just are not a beautiful group. And so I'm like, it's not possible. I cannot be related to them. But yet, sadly, I guess in profile there is a possibility that is my mother that is there on the throne, looking like one of the males. And I am thinking, well, gosh dang it, it's not a beautiful profile, is it? And so, maybe they painted over the paintings, you know. I'm thinking this also, you know, after the French Revolution, they could have painted over the paintings to make them extra ugly. They could be doctoring up the paintings also in Britain, making them extra beautiful. Gosh dang it, I'm starting to look like my mother a little bit. It's freaking me out. Okay, well, anyway. I'm sorry. Try not to be so small, little brother. Try not to be so small, you know. You have a family, and they have their history also. It's not only about you. Oh yeah, billions of people. Billions of people are affected by your decisions. Maybe that's what it is. You know, we're dealing with a coward. I don't want to call you a coward over the email. I'll do it right here in public, in front of everyone.